गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी डेटाबेस कनेक्शन, दैट इज फ्रंट एंड एंड बैक एंड, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट द डेटाबेस इन SQLite. सो वी आर यूजिंग SQLite एज अ डेटाबेस एंड द फ्रंट एंड, दैट इज ऑफकोर्स द एंड्रॉइड स्टूडियो. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ एंड्रॉइड स्टूडियो. सो वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ डेटाबेस कनेक्शन, वी रिक्वायर थ्री फाइल्स. नंबर वन, दैट इज XML फाइल फॉर द फ्रंट एंड. सेकेंड, एक्चुअल जावा प्रोग्राम. एंड थर्ड, द डेटाबेस फाइल. Now here is the class we have created. The class name is SQLite Database Handler. Now this is a Java file. So what we have to do? Just right click on the package. Now click on the new and click on the Java class. When you click the Java class, here we have to give a name as a SQLite Database Handler. So this is simply Java class. Once you create a Java class, so in this Java class there is no set content layout. So when you check out entire code, there is no set content layout. So this code is for insert, update, delete and select. So all these things, all database queries are generated at one file. So I have written a code and I have written functions for every scenario. One for the insert, second for the delete, update and select. So what we have to do, first create SQLite database handler class. And it should extend a class SQLite OpenHelper. So this is very important. We have to extend the class SQLite OpenHelper. Now where this class is present? This class is present in android.database.sqlite.sqlite.openhelper. So one thing that we have to import a class SQLite OpenHelper. Once you extend this class, you will get some methods automatic. One of the method is SQLite database handler. This is the constructor. So public SQLite database handler. And this is the context, and the object name is context. Now we will see the variables one by one. Now whenever you are going to create a database, now from the front end, automatically a database is created, and this database is in the SQLite. So we are going to open that SQLite database also. So first variable is private static final, that is constant string database name. Database name is registerDB. So this is the database name. By this name, database is created. Second, that is table name. Table name is login. So private static final string table name. So table name is a login. Second, we require the columns. So third variable is private static final string column name is username, and a private static final string column 2 is password. So we have to create a database. We have to create a login. We have to create a username and password. Next is database version. So private static final integer database version is 1. Now this is the constructor. Now of course we have to give the values for the constructor. Super keyword for calling super base class constructor. Context, this is nothing but the context is a class. The context gives the references. Now we have to provide a database name. We have to provide the factory, that is null, and we have to provide a database version. By default, database version is 1. So this is the default version. Now these are the variables we have to provide to a super. Now by using this constructor, database gets created. Second, I want to create a table. So I'm going to write public void onCreate. So this is the method we want to override. SQLite database. So this is a class present in the android.database.sqlite.sqlite.database. So this is SQLite database and the object is DB. Now query will be, string query is create table. Table name is register user. So either you can use like this, otherwise you can use login as a table name also. So string query, that is create table, register user, username text and password is text. After that, db.execute query. Now once you call this method execute execsql and this query, that means the table gets created. So by using this constructor, database created, and using this function, the table gets created. Now second method, that is upgrade, public void on upgrade SQLite DB and version and integer version. It means if I want to override a new database version by the old one, then this method is called. Now these three methods are automatically called. These three methods are, we have to override when you extend the class SQLite OpenHelper. So when you write extends SQL at Open Helper, these three functions are written over here. Now what the functions we have to write, that is below this comment we have to write the function. Now we'll check the functions one by one. Now function one, that is public long create user. This is the method we have created. So public long create user, string username and string password. These are the values we have to pass. Now this method we have to call at the button click event. SQLite DB class name DB is equal to this dot get writable, because we want to write the user values. We want to write the username and password. So I'm calling the method get writable database. So this dot get writable database means we want to write. Now the content values is equal to new content values. So the content value is the class. It has a put method. This is the column name, username, and exact value will be passed when you call the function. Second, that is value put password. Now long result is equal to db.insert. Insert is again the method. So when you call an insert method, we have to give the table name in which table you want to insert the values. So table name is register values. And what are the values? Values are nothing but it is object of a content values. And after that db.close, and we have to return the result. So this value is going to check. So whether this value is going to give the 0 or 1, depending on the value, the data is written or not written, it is going to check it. So this is the code for adding the values into a table, or writing the values into a table, or inserting a values into a table. So again, the function name is createUser. We have passed two parameters. These two parameters we have put in the content values, and by using insert method, we want to give the values and the table name. Now, once you insert values, we want to check whether this username and password exist or not. If the username and password is matched, then I want to go in the next screen. That is, we have seen in the previous videos also. But now what we have to do, we have to use a database. Now we are not using hard code values, but we are going to check in the database. Now we want to pass username and password. So check user is a function. Now this is the boolean value, so it is going to return either true or false. So check user and passing the values of username and password. Now this is array we have want to write. So string array of columns is equal to column 1 and column 2. Second, SQLite DB is equal to get readable database. This get readable database, it is a method we have to call. When you call this method, the value is assigned to DB. Now next we have to check selection. Username is equal to question mark and password is equal to question mark. This is query. This question mark is nothing but we have to give the input. Username we have to give the input. Password we have to give the input. Now string selection arguments are username and password. Now the cursor is nothing but when we want to retrieve the rows from the table, we are going to use cursor. Cursor is used to temporarily store the data in the memory. So cursor object created as a cursor is equal to db.query. Now db is an object of the SQLite database, and the query we want to give as the table name. Table name is register user. Second is columns. What are the columns we want to map? So the columns are nothing but column 1 and column 2. Now what will be the selection? Selection will be username and password. These are the columns password. These are the columns names. Now again, selection arguments are username and password. So after that, group by, having and order by, that we want to don't want to set. So I kept as a null. After that, we are going to check when we want to execute this. When the query is executed, we want to check how many rows are retrieved. So that will be stored in the cursor. So cursor dot get count. We want to check what is the count. So integer count is the value, and after that we want to close the cursor. Now if the count is greater than 0, return true, otherwise return false. It means that if the cursor has a more than 0 value, it means username and password is exist. If it is 0 or it is a 0 value, then it is a false. So like this we can create a function, or we can write a function to check whether the user exists or not. If the user exists, we want to go at the next screen. Next is for the update user. Now suppose I want to change anything, like suppose I want to change a password, then I can write the update query like this. So the method name is update user. We want to pass username and password. Now again, updating means we want to write into a database. So get writable database. So SQLite db is equal to this.get writable database. So the content value is equal to new content values. So the content values are always used when we want to insert into data, and cursor is always used when we want to retrieve the data. So always keep in mind that the content value is a class when we want to insert the values, and the cursor is a class when we want to retrieve the values. So the content values is the object is equal to new content values. Now values.put is username and password, and these are the username and password values. These values are passed when we call this function. Now we are calling the update query. So db.update the table name, we want to give in which table we want to update. Now what are the values? So these values are there, where column 1 is equal to question mark, it means we are giving the username, and is equal to new string.value of username. So we are going to give the username and it is going to update it. So after that we want to close the database. So db.close. So db is nothing but SQLite database object. So this was for the updating the user. After that there is a function for the delete user. Now suppose I want to delete a user, this is same. So db SQLite database db is equal to this.getWritable. We are calling getWritable function. After that we want to call a delete method.